We have more news coming in at this point in time. This has got again to do with the Champions Trophy. Clearly, India versus Pakistan showdown here. Intelligence agencies issuing Pakistan a terror dossier. India says no to playing cricket in Pakistan. Intelligence agencies have issued a detailed dossier on Pakistan's involvement in supporting harboring terrorist organizations. This dossier, a comprehensive report on terror activities originating from Pakistan's soil, outlines numerous attacks carried out by groups that are actively backed by Islamabad. Evidence within the dossier points to direct involvement and logistical support provided by Pakistan-based terror organizations. Now, as per reports, the International Cricket Council, ICC, has officially requested a written explanation from the BCCI regarding its decision. The request reported by Pakistan's Jio News highlights the broader implications of global cricketing events and potential disruptions to the sport's international calendar. Indian cricketers, officials have voiced unanimous support for the BCCI's stance, emphasizing that player safety remains paramount. Shivani Sharma getting in more details on that story. Shivani, the reaction then, hence, of the ICC, obviously expected, because safety of our players has always been a concern in Pakistan, and it's not just Indian players. This obviously raises question mark on whether Pakistan can A, handle events of this nature. Champions Trophy is being held there. What about players from other countries who will actually be playing the tournament in Pakistan?
See, Sneha, Pakistan remains exposed globally for supporting terror on its soil. And the recent decision by the BCCI regarding cricketers' security concerns when they go to Pakistan is also being supported unanimously, not only by Indian cricketers, but the Indian community and the community globally. And now the intelligence agencies have brought out a dossier. This is a comprehensive report of all the terror attacks that Pakistan supported terrorist organizations have been conducting on Indian soil. And they are being supported from Pakistan organizations in Pakistan, and the documents that have been taken from them after these terrorists have been neutralized, they clearly show that they have been living in Pakistan for years, planning attacks on India while they were in Pakistan. They were being supported by Pakistani government and all the establishments out there. There was no fear onto them in Pakistan. And this is another exposed how Pakistan has been harboring terrorism, and especially against India. It has been promoting, in fact, the terror organizations because it hasn't taken any action. And this particular data pertains to all those terror attacks that have happened, especially in the recent years and also after the attacks on Mumbai. So this is the dossier of all those hundreds of terror attacks that Pakistan attempted against Indian citizens, infiltrated inside Indian boundaries and then got neutralized. And the weapon systems, the weapons, the guns, the weapons and the cash of Pakistani currency, the medicines. So it all clearly shows, this is evidence enough to show how Pakistan has been promoting, harboring terrorism. And so the decision by the BCCI not to send the cricket team in India is a very strong and a very appropriate decision. Sneha.
You know, this is in fact an issue that has been voiced by India time and again, isn't it? You know, take us through the details of this dossier as far as the big concerns are here, really, because this has been, like I said, raised time and again. It's not the first occasion.
Certainly, Sneha. This dossier clearly shows all those incidents, all those recent terror incidents that have happened in India by these Pakistani terrorists. And recently, India Today has also broken a report about how 119 foreign terrorists are active in Jammu and Kashmir, and how India has been neutralizing, Indian forces have been neutralizing all these terror attempts inside India's boundary. And we've also heard the voices of Dr. S. Jaishankar and all the representatives of India across UN Security Council on how India has been facing terrorism from Pakistan, and Pakistan has failed to act. In fact, it has chosen not to act against terrorism on its soil, and it has been promoting. So in this dossier, we see a lot of weapons that have been seized from the neutralized terrorists, the Pakistani terrorists. We also see different attacks and when they happened and the kind of planning they had been doing in Pakistan and then infiltrating Indian borders. So this is an evidence of how Pakistan has been promoting terrorist terror organizations, and that's why India's decision not to send the cricket team to Pakistan is valid.
Right, I'm going to, in fact, just come back to you, Shivani Sharma, in a moment from now. Rahul Rawat also getting in more details. Rahul, I think this just, you know, in a way underscores what our concerns are. This isn't, you know, this is so much more about our security, the security of our players, the safety of our players. Obviously, we can't play cricket in a country which gives no guarantee and, in fact, supports terrorists who could be, in fact, harming the players. This has happened in the past as well. We know about it. Intelligence agencies giving just so many more reasons why in that detailed dossier on why Indian cricketers can't play cricket there, isn't it?
True, Sneha. Yes. In fact, the ICC, basically when BCCI conveyed to ICC that the government has refused our travel to Pakistan for the Champions Trophy, PCB asked ICC that if they can get a detailed report as to why the Indian team doesn't want to travel to Pakistan. So after that, the BCCI had sent a detailed dossier to the ICC mentioning the terror activities that have happened in Pakistan in the last 10 to 15 years and making it very clear that the Indian players, even the fans, would be traveling from India across the border to witness the championship trophy, just in case if it was to happen, their safety and security was at massive risk. In fact, they've mentioned that the Indian players could be high potential targets if they do visit to Pakistan. And you know, it's a different matter if an Australian team or an English team is traveling to Pakistan. But when it comes to India traveling to Pakistan, we all know what all can happen. In fact, what we've seen in the last 70 odd years, the terror activities. In fact, last month only, Dr. S. Jaishankar, our foreign minister, traveled to Pakistan, and there were rumors only and only from Pakistan that he had bilateral talks with the officials from the Pakistan government that cricket diplomacy could resume again. But from the Indian government or from the BCCI, there were no such details shared. In fact, they never said that there were any conversations that happened regarding this cricket diplomacy. So India, the BCCI, in fact, has shared a detailed dossier as to what all has happened in Pakistan in the last 10 to 15 years. And now how Pakistan wants to make it a political statement. Look at, you know, they in fact tweeted yesterday and announced with much fanfare. By the way, Twitter is blocked over there in Pakistan. And on Twitter, they announced that the trophy tour will happen in four cities, three out of which happened to be in Pakistan.
That's right. And that's what the controversy was about, India, which also, in fact, led to this this hue and cry, and rightly so. Rahul, I'm going to thank you for the moment. Also, thanking Shivani for getting in her perspective in those details and that big story that we are tracking.